What about online resources? Have you gone through any online resources?
Not specifically, but I looked for anything that I could not understand.
Okay.
I definitely Googled it and then tried to find out the best way that I can understand that.
Mm-hmm. And there are availability of these many photocopies and all. What can we do about that? It means finding the right material among them is a bit difficult, right?
Definitely, but I think guidance from seniors helps here, because I had a few seniors who were preparing along with me.
Mm-hmm.
And I took their word on face value and just followed them as far as resources are concerned.
It has been observed that there is difference in marks between successful students who study from the same teachers and from the those who are not successful. What do you think are the reasons for that?
I think that marks are a result of many factors. There is a lot of variability involved, and we cannot say that if two students who have studied from the same teacher, from the same material, will get the same score, because they are two different human beings. There is not any correlation between these two.
Okay. If you can delineate a proper strategy for preparation, what would it be for the overall examination?
Okay. First of all, I told you that you break the syllabus down so that you can understand the syllabus.
Mm-hmm.
And the syllabus does not bog you down.
Mm-hmm.
First of all, that is there. Second thing is you gather few resources based on the advice by your seniors or by toppers, and you look for the resources, you find out the best resource, and then you read it, and then you reread it, and then you revise it.
Mm-hmm.
So reading one source multiple times.
Okay.
Then you can divide your syllabus in some bits and parts, so that some things are more important and some things are less important by looking at the previous year question papers. So the things that are more important you can prepare in great detail and just go through the rest of the topics quickly. And then beyond all this, the most important thing is that you need to have a very good opinion of yourself. You need to have a good self-confidence. You need to have a belief that you will make it, because eventually attitude and belief will take you through the examination.
In mains examination, one should follow interdisciplinary approach, and the same is the case with the questions also. So how can one develop that interdisciplinary approach?
My optional was geography. So geography is an interdisciplinary subject because it encompasses all, even history, even geopolitics, so political science is there, even society we studied about.
Mm-hmm.
So that is why, because of the optional, the interdisciplinary approach was developed automatically, and that helped me in GS as well.
Okay. And can essay be prepared from essay specific classroom classes, just like the general studies and all?
Essay is a written test of your personality, according to me, because at the mains level you get to write your thoughts for 3 long hours for just on 2 topics. So essay preparation lies with 2 aspects: one, your thought process, and other, your material, the content that you have. So content can definitely be taken from the GS preparation, and the thought process or the structuring of your essay,
mm-hmm.
that I think needs to be practiced upon repeatedly, and there is no such correlation between an essay specific class or anything like that.
Okay. And ethics paper, it's a very dynamic paper, but over the years it has been noted that the questions are very easy, but scoring marks has been difficult. Can you state why?
Ethics paper is ethics paper also. What do you think? Basically, you write that because the time crunch is there. The paper is lengthy, so the difference in marks is definitely because of 2 reasons. One, definitely the solution that you think of the problem of the case study that is there, And secondly, the way you write it, the way of your expression. So the difference in marks definitely lies in the way of expression.
Mm-hmm. You said writing is important. So how can one develop this writing skill in the course of examination, in the course of preparation?
Writing skill, any skill can be developed by practice. So writing skill can also be developed by practice. The more you write, mm-hmm. The better your skill will be.
Mm-hmm.
So do not hesitate from writing. Keep on writing. Write as much as you can. Anything that you are reading, always keep a paper and pen with you. And just even if you jot down a few points, that also helps.
Okay.
So do not just read anything. Always read and then note. Always read and then write.
In this scenario, how helpful are the test series?
Test series are definitely helpful, but I did not perform very good in the test series, and I did not write many tests. I wrote a few tests only, but I was planning to write even more tests in my next attempt.
Okay.
So test series are definitely helpful. Test series give you an idea of what you are going to face in the examination.
And when do you think this optimal time for giving a test series?
For optional subject, I think you should prepare your optional fully before the prelims examination.
Okay.
And you write multiple tests between the prelims and mains examination.
Okay.
And for GS, I think you keep on writing the tests as you prepare.
Did you find it is necessary to study the whole syllabus, because the whole syllabus of UPSC means it's a vast thing? So is it necessary to cover the entire syllabus? Is it possible?
That's what I told you, that you divide the syllabus into different parts. You will see some parts of the syllabus are very crucial, very important, repeated almost every year. So those parts you prepare in detail, and among the rest of the topics you can pick and choose. And definitely you have to skip certain topics, because either they are not that relevant as far as questions are concerned, or they are too dynamic to be completely prepared.
Can you give some insights on how you prepare subject wise, both GS and optional?
GS, for paper 1, most of my preparation is based upon NCRTs and the core books.
Okay.
So I have read NCRTs multiple times.
Okay.
So for GS1, for example, for history, for art and culture, I prepared everything from the NCRTs, and the geography part was my optional part, so I didn't need to have the specific preparation for geography.
Yes.
For GS2, polity paper and governance, I relied on the current affairs, and I tried to find out the reason for certain government policies, the need for the certain government policies and their impact. And for the IR part, I developed certain bullet points on which the international relations vary, on which the international relations depend. So along those lines, I wrote answers in GS2.
Okay.
For GS3, again, agriculture and Indian economy part was a bit covered in my optional. For the rest of the paper, I again relied on the newspaper, because GS2 and GS3 can be comprehensively covered through newspaper. For ethics, I did not read anything specifically. For optional, for geography optional, there are specific books for different topics that are there in the geography optional. And along with the books, certain materials from various teachers that are there, that are available in this field, they helped.
Okay. Have you taken any coaching, sir?
Yes, I joined coaching for my optional subject. I joined coaching for test series, because coachings have been an important part during my preparation.
Okay. But many of the aspirants rely heavily on coaching for the success. Is it the right way?
The blend between, basically coaching is that somebody is guiding you, somebody is teaching you what you can read from yourself as well. So there needs to be a blend between the coaching and self-study, because you cannot rely on coaching fully, because that is spoon-feeding, that does not develop your aptitude. And also you As far as self-study is concerned, there are not all things are available in books. You need to refer certain materials by good teachers who are involved in UPSC preparation. So a good blend of both is required.
Okay. And can you give us some insights on your interview?
My interview was with Madam Sujata Mehta board.
Okay.
It was a very good interview, very cordial interview board. And I think that the interview board is equipped enough to bring out your true personality in half an hour. So I prepared my DAF, I prepared my bit on my graduation subject and my optional, and relied heavily on the current affairs going on. I think the interview went well. Questions were asked on geography and culture, on India being a developing country and the road to become a developed country, and things about agriculture, agricultural income, MSP, and certain areas from my DAF.
Any suggestions for those who are starting preparation?
Those who are starting preparation should first of all look for the reason that why they are starting, because that reason is what that will motivate you through the long years of preparation. Because definitely the journey is long, the journey needs dedication, needs determination, perseverance, and first of all they should look for the reason that why they want to be an IAS, and that should be a strong one. After that they must look for guidance from the seniors available or the guidance from online resources, and then chart out a strategy and keep on doing the work, stay motivated, believe in yourself.
Any suggestions for those who failed or those who didn't get a cut in this interview process?
Few of my friends who are more intelligent than me, who are more hardworking than me, unfortunately could not make it in this attempt. But the only thing that is required is you gather yourself and you look right into the mirror and think that you can do it. The belief that you can do it, the more times you reinforce it, the more you will have the belief that you definitely can do it. And for those who failed in this attempt, I wish them all the best to make it in the next one. Right now prelims is approaching, so give the next 30 days for prelims, give your best, because the time is less and you definitely need to have another shot at the services.
Often everyone talks about what should be done while preparing. Can you give us some examples on what should not be done while preparation?
That is more important, what should not be done. Because the plethora of resources that are available, they bog you down, they confuse you, what should be done, what should not be done. So first of all, what should not be done, number one, reading multiple sources for the same thing once or twice, that should not be done.
Okay.
That is the most crucial thing. Second is, do not give up. There will be phases in the preparation when you will feel very low, when you will feel that the process is very difficult. But if you stay motivated, if you can motivate yourself every day, if you have good friends, if you have supporting friends who can motivate you every day, because the role of my friends in my success is immense. A few of my friends, they motivated me regularly. In fact, right before my mains examination, I was thinking of skipping the mains exam because I thought that I was not well prepared. And one of my friends, he motivated me and inspired me to begin afresh in the last 20 days. And then I revised all of my syllabus and then I got confidence. So in this way, the role of friends is very crucial. So the thing is that you should not give up. So these two things, in my opinion, are most important.
And what is the role of Civil Services Chronicle in your preparation?
I specifically did not refer to Civil Services as Chronicle, But definitely the magazines are a boon for those who do not have access to the regular resources, the daily newspapers. And definitely Civil Services Chronicle like magazines, they provide a concise and a crisp material, crisp look into all the current happenings that are happening around. And that is definitely beneficial for your preparation.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.